Welcome back to my channel, everyone. This is MagAlpha03 here, and today I'll be reviewing the Valken Black Tactical Goggles and the Damascus Hardshell Imperial Kneepads. Now, there's a couple important things that I and Neil will discuss shortly during this video, so let's get started. Begin with the black tactical goggles manufactured by Valken. Now, Valken has a pretty good grip in quality when it comes to their tactical goggles, so it is one of the good brands to buy from when it comes to headgear. Now, I bought these around 7 months ago, so they aren't that old. However, they still are worth an investment since they are part of the latest generation of airsoft headgear produced by Valken. Now, this pair and other similar ones shouldn't cost more than 30 to 35 bucks, as long as they aren't something like the night vision goggles that normally cost about 110 bucks. Generally, any pair of these should fall between the $30 to $35 range if they don't have any extra special features. Like any other pair of tactical goggles, however, this model does come with pros and cons, regardless of price. I often wear it while playing airsoft, and it is a winner when it comes to its efficiency protection, and it is quite resistant to the impact generated by even the hardest BB collisions. Given the fact that its lens is made of mesh, as you can see here, get a close up, it does present a formidable advantage as it prevents fogginess since air can enter and escape freely through the holes. As you can see here, it's mesh. So there's kind of these holes that air can go through. So that way it also acts kind of like a vent, allowing cool air to circulate since it can get pretty hot inside what you're wearing, a helmet and, you know, other face cover. Which brings me to also mention the fact that it does look good on almost any airsoft helmet, regardless of size, because some pairs are too wide, some too narrow, you name it. Also, what stands out when it comes to quality is the polyurethane frame, as you can see around here. Now, this frame comes in almost any other airsoft, you know, goggles. You know, it doesn't necessarily have to be made by Valken, but, you know, this is a common material that you'd find on the frame of airsoft goggles. But, you know, when it comes to comfort, and that's what I really like about this pair of goggles, is the interior silicone frame that you can see around here. Now, this isn't often found in many airsoft goggles because some of them have their interior frame made of rubber instead of silicone. And, you know, when that happens, when you're wearing it, it can create, you know, kind of like a tight feeling. It can be, you know, pretty uncomfortable, especially around the nose area here. So, you know, if you happen to have a pair of goggles that has a rubber interior frame, then you're likely to have issues with its comfort, and it might leave marks on your nose and on your face in general. But that's what I like about the silicone frame. It does not leave discomfort or does not leave marks whatsoever. Now, of all these advantages that should be considering factors when you're purchasing airsoft goggles, they do come at a cost. Like I previously mentioned, this pair of goggles scores pretty well for being highly durable and comfortable, but there are a few setbacks. A lot of these airsoft goggles come in with removable side panels that allow goggles to be attached to your airsoft helmet if it does come with secure hooks. And that's the first issue with this pair of goggles. As you can see, it does not come with removable side panels. You can't take those off. You're just gonna end up breaking the goggles. And even with the top mesh lining right here, you can see here through the mesh lining that even the holes are too small for the hooks to be able to enter in and out. Therefore, that renders this pair of goggles completely unattachable. You're just gonna have to put them behind your helmet to keep them in place, especially the strap. And second issue with this pair of goggles is that even though the mesh can successfully withstand, you know, even the hardest hits, but it can still present a risk of injury to the eye. Now, the BB may not damage the mesh that's on here, but sometimes Airsoft bullets hit hard enough on any surface and they will end up breaking, which results in, you know, tiny fragments of the Airsoft BB entering through these holes and getting into the eye. Now, this is unlikely to happen because, you know, often these holes are small enough for almost nothing to enter in, but it could happen. Sometimes BBs, when they hit a hard surface, they do explode into many fragments that could possibly enter through here. You know, it isn't likely, but still very possible. Final issue that I want to document about these goggles is that they are pretty durable. And like I mentioned before, the silicone frame around here on the interior, even though it does create comfort, it also creates other problems. Now, generally, airsoft bullets, when they hit any surface, the impact they generate isn't really that much, unless you're going on full auto, or unless if it's a grenade or anything that generates a lot of BBs at a really fast speed. But the fact that, you know, the silicone interior frame right here, it's not as tight. So often, you know, from impact, when a lot of BBs are hitting you at once, the goggles can slip. Especially the nose piece right here. It does get pretty slippery, and you're just gonna have to readjust the pair of goggles and put them back on whenever they fall down. And even if you tighten the strap, you know, you can tighten the strap to, you know, any tightness of your liking, depending on your pair of comfort, but even with that, sometimes the nose piece tends to slip down. So that is the final issue with this pair of goggles. Everything else it is good at. Those are the only three major setbacks that I found while using these goggles. All right, now let's move on to the knee pads. These are the Damascus Hardshell Imperial knee pads, black on black as shown. From what I know, Damascus is a less known brand of airsoft products since I haven't really seen any airsoft players use their products. And that's no surprise considering that their brand is named after a real life city. Jokes aside, I haven't tested out or purchased any of their products other than these knee pads, which cost around $20. They come at a reasonable price as opposed to Condor and Valken knee pads, which come at a few dollars more expensive. At first sight, they don't really seem much, but they do have a few good things to offer that outnumber the bad things. I just kind of wish that their design would have been more detailed and looked better than its basic flat looked. Because if you compare it with, you know, other knee pads, their shell has a more beveled look. You know, see here, this is just curved and flat. Now, the Valken knee pads, they did not give much comfort while kneeling, and it kind of gave my kneecaps a weird feeling to them. Now, this could possibly be from the top beveled notch of the hard shell that's on the padding. Or as I like to call it, the summit of the shell, when it's pressing on the ground when kneeling, even though both shells are made from the same material called polyurethane. I also noticed how paint on the Valken shell started to deteriorate after only a few uses, while this knee pad hardly shows any scratches. So you can see here on the Valken knee pad, at the edges, you can see how the paint's starting to wear off, even though I only used it for a couple times. But here on the Damascus knee pad, you know, no disintegrated paint, no, hardly any scratches, nothing at all. But I do like the Valken knee pad design, and I'm talking about the design of the shell. You know, in comparison to the design of the Damascus hard shell. Because, you know, I think the beveled, you know, shell is more attractive, but as in terms of comfort, you know, the Damascus is more efficient. All right, so going back to the Damascus hard shell knee pads, what I also like about these knee pads is the material on the back, which, you know, corresponds with the padding. And in addition to the design of the shell, it creates additional comfort when you're kneeling. That's what I like about, you know, this knee pad in general when it comes to both the shell and the padding. And, you know, they both have to do with the materials used in the manufacturing of the knee pad. I also like the straps on the back of this Kneepad. They are pretty long and they're made to extend. So, you know, you can fit it on almost any foot size as compared to the Valken Kneepads, which their straps were, you know, more short and more tight. Now, of course, this would depend on what size of Kneepads you get. It is important to make sure that you get the same size, but you know, regardless of size, I'm seeing these straps and I've used them. They're just more comfortable and they go more around than the Valken Kneepads. Now, I went over the things that I like about these Kneepads and I pretty much covered them all in general, but I do have two things that I would say I dislike about these Kneepads. Now, the first thing I already mentioned before about the design of these Kneepads is the shell, which of course I don't like the, you know, flat design, like I said. And you know, along with the six ring design on each Kneepad, it just kind of makes the Kneepad look more, you know, like a skating Kneepad, or, you know, for skateboarding, for BMX, or for any other type of sport, and it does not really look like an Airsoft Kneepad, even though allegedly this product is made for Airsoft. So that's the first thing that I don't like about this Kneepad. Second thing is that even though the straps are, you know, pretty extendable and they are comfortable on your leg, they do tend to leave out a lot of loose string that I have to cut off. Now, most of them that have shown, I've cut off here, but as you can see here, for example, there's that piece of loose string right there that was going out. That's what it often tends to leave out. And I have to cut these, and it just does that often, unlike the other Valken Kneepads. See, there's also loose string down here. That's what I'd usually have to cut out of the straps. So those are only two things that I don't like about the Kneepad, but you know, everything else, it is pretty good. And like I said, it's more than the bad things. So overall, I would say that these Kneepads are pretty good. You know, could be a good investment. They come at a reasonable price and they are worth their money. But of course, they only come these two bad things. But other than that, if you are looking for a comfortable pair of Kneepads, I would recommend these Kneepads, especially. If you don't find them, you know, sold at your local Airsoft arena, you can order them online. Now, I bought them from my local Airsoft arena, but, you know, like I said, this brand isn't popular as much, so you're not likely to find it in other, you know, Airsoft stores. So here are my opinions and personal experiences with using both of these products. And I would say I would equally recommend both of these products because they both share an almost equal amount of pros and they only have a few cons that are holding them back. But overall, they are, you know, good investments of gear if you are looking for good gear that could give you more advantages in the long run. But I do hope this helped. And thank you for watching this video, and please make sure to subscribe and like for future reviews on more gear.